probably will be the coolest video I have done so far. I'm outside my office in Gdańsk, Poland, and will show you how to do an aerial visualization from start to finish. We'll start with taking a drone photography through camera matching in 3ds Max, creating lighting that matches the photo, blending 3D with the drone shot, and finally putting everything together to achieve the effect like this. This video wouldn't happen without Glowplans, which is the sponsor of this video. We'll start with shooting a photo with a drone. Using drones in aerial visualizations is a must in my opinion. Doing everything in 3D looks fake in most cases, and it's not up to today's standards for marketing type of work. Also, if you can do it all by yourself, it's a great way to make some extra money. I am using DJI Mini 3 Pro. It's a great choice because it weighs less than 250 grams, so you can fly it everywhere. Doesn't matter if you have a drone license or not, and at the same time, the quality is really good for a drone that size. This is the site I will use for this tutorial. We have a great location here, close to the park and sea. The city is on another side. Here, we have to think about what we want to show. Of course, in this case, we have to show a connection with the park and sea and hide the city on another side. The time of the day is also very important. To get good lighting, choose either early morning or late afternoon. I like to catch a bit of sun, but have it nice and soft. All the composition rules apply here. We can turn on grid lines in contrast settings, so it's way easier to get the best angle. To do so, we need to go to settings, choose camera, scroll down to grid lines. I like to choose this too. Now it's way easier to get the best angle. Now let me show you what camera settings I change to get the best possible outcome. First, I change the photo size to 48 megapixels. I always shoot in RAW format to have more control in post-production later. I switch to Pro mode and adjust the shutter speed and ISO manually. The cool thing about this drone is that you can shoot vertical images. You can rotate the camera with a click of one button. It's a way better solution than cropping from horizontal to vertical. Here is the shot I came up with. I am happy with them. Let's go back to the office. Hope you liked the first part. Let me know in the comments if you would like to see more videos like this. The first step is to do a post-production on the RAW photo. We have a JPEG and DNG, and I will use DNG as it stores way more information. Usually, I use Lightroom for that, but I will use Photoshop because probably most of you guys use it. I will start by darkening the highlights so we will see the sea more clearly. By the way, you can download the photo and the site model from my website, the link in the corner and in the description, so you can follow along. Then I will work on the overall brightness and contrast of the image. We can add a bit of clarity and texture, but not too much. We can adjust the contrast further in the curves tab. Lastly, I will work on colors a bit. Let's make the water even more noticeable, as this is the most important feature of this location. We can change the hue a bit as well. I am happy with that. Now, let's jump to 3ds Max to do the first step in 3D, which is camera matching. First, we need a Google Maps screenshot so we have some reference. I have painted over the main paths, so it's more visible. Here, you can see the scale. I will move the pivot to one end of the scale. Then, I will create a plane with a length of 200 meters. Move the map to one side of the plane and scale it to match the size. Great! Now, let's add the drone photo as a background. Go to Configure Viewport, Background, and use the file. One more thing, we have to match the output resolution to the photo size. To find out the resolution of the photography, go to Properties and Details. Here is the resolution. Type it in the output size. Preparation is done. Now we can create a camera. In the photo details, you can find all the information about camera settings. We have to use these settings in 3ds Max. I will change the type to focal length. Set film width to 35 mm and focal length to 24 mm, as it says in the photo details. Let's set other values. In V-Ray, it works exactly the same, only the naming is slightly different. Once it's done, let's set the height of the camera. It's way easier if you know the altitude of a drone. When I shot this photo, my drone was 120 meters above the ground. Then, let's turn on the horizon line and adjust the camera's target to match the horizon of the photo. Now that the camera height and the viewing angle are set, we can group the camera and its target and move and rotate it as a whole. To make it easier, we can decrease the opacity of the Google Maps material. The only thing left is to adjust it as close as possible. I think it's pretty good. Let's see how it looks with the site models. This is the model. I used the building from Evermotion. I will link them in the description below. All looks fine. I'm happy with that. Great, we have the camera. Now we need to match the lighting. Let me turn on all the layers so we can see the complete model. The trees and vegetation we use come from glow plants. You know that high quality is very important for me. Glow plant models are not only very detailed and photorealistic, but also have really well done materials. You can buy individual models or bundles. It's very convenient. Let's say you work on a project in New Zealand. Just choose this bundle and you are covered. They create exact plant species. My client wants a jacaranda tree, so here it is. You get not only these models, but also different growth stages. Also, all the models are available in a GrowFX version, which is really important for me, as I am not locked to the models they have created and can adjust them to my need, like in this image. If you cannot find the model you need, don't worry, just email them and they will custom make it for you. I will put the link to their website in the corner and the description below. Now let's add the sun. I will use the daylight system. We have to match the north to the north of the Google Maps backdrop. Next, we have to jump to the motion tab and pick the location. We're in Europe. Warsaw, Poland is the closest. Then I will set the date and the time. This information can be found in the photography details. Once it's done, let's move to Modify panel and change the sun type to Corona. If you use V-Ray, obviously choose it instead. We don't need a skylight as we'll use Corona Sky. Also, let's set up a light mix so we have more control later on. Let's see how it looks rendered. Obviously, too bright. First, I will lower exposure. -1.5 looks correct. I will add a bit of contrast and desaturate it a bit. Then, let's jump to the light mix tab and make the sun more orange. Also, I will make sky more blue. We are getting there. Now, if I place it over the background image, you can notice that this area here stands out a lot because it should be in the shadow cast by these trees. We need to add the surrounding trees in 3ds Max, so they can cast shadows on our main models. I have added a plane and two layers of trees. The outer layers using Forest Pack plugin, and for the inner layer, I've just used proxies and placed them more precisely manually to match the photo. Here is how it looks rendered. We don't need them visible though, we just need shadows. I will make them invisible to the camera. Go to Object Properties and uncheck Visible to Camera. Same for the trees. This way, they won't be rendered, but they still will cast shadows. Here is how it looks rendered. I am happy with that. We can render high resolution. Now let's combine the render with the photo. When the render is ready, we need to place the main image over the drawn photo. Remember to save it as EXR or TIFF so you have an alpha channel stored. Add a mask to the render and mask out the trees in front of this site. Here is the final effect. It's quite a long process. The more time you put in, the better effect you will achieve. I will add a curves adjustment layer only to the render to blend it better. Next, I will add levels and make the rendering way darker. Then, I will make a mask black so the effect is not visible and paint some areas with the white brush to add shadows. I will also desaturate the render a bit. You can notice that the render is way sharper than the photo, so they don't blend well. We need to add some filters to fix this. first. I will add motion blur because the drone camera is moving a bit, which creates a bit of motion blur on the photo. Not too much. Free is fine. I will add normal blur as well to make it even less sharp. Then, let's add a noise, as it's a bit visible in the photo. And finally, I will sharpen the image. I'm adding it because drone software sharpens photos, so it will match this effect. Look at the difference. Now, they look way better together. The very important last step is to add some color correction to both layers so they blend even more. I will add some contrast and vignetting and change the colors a bit. Here is the final effect. If you want to learn how to create advanced exterior visualizations from start to finish, join my course. Also, watch my other videos here on YouTube. These are my picks. Bye bye!